Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Data Dispatch. Hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Let's talk about what we got going on in the market today, especially with an analyst that comes out here and predicts that Palantir Technologies could double in its price. And another interesting thing that we see today in today's trading action is Palantir has a relatively good green day that could be correlated, of course, with some of this news. In light of a red market that we are seeing continuing to see a little bit of a pullback, and this could be likely due to the further expectations and increased probability that we will see the first interest rate cuts possibly coming September. We also have some interesting volatility variables that are happening with NVIDIA and other large semiconductor stocks. What are we talking about? So big things ahead. Make sure you stay tuned. We have a lot to talk about, especially earnings now are going to be coming up here in a few short weeks for Palantir Technologies. So if you are a new or returning viewer, hit that like button, subscribe for daily videos. And of course, I'm not a financial advisor. I'm collecting all the data and dispatching it to you. Pop it up on the screen here. What we see with Palantir doing well, up about 2%, including the after hours. And right now at 28.80. Market close at 28.64. In terms of actual volume, looking good. 76 million right now. Now, this is higher than what we've been typically seeing around that $40 to $50 million kind of volume area. But what we see with Palantir Technologies is testing this resistance that we're seeing basically here at the 29s and possibly in the 30s. One key thing that we are seeing, daily short volume actually decreased from the day before, which is looking good. And this is telling me that some of the bigger investors that are taking large short positions are changing their perspective and could be playing and trading on the news that we got today and the earnings play. Now, what we see here, Weebush says that Palantir stock, and they've always been typically pretty bullish, Dan Ives here, could nearly double from here. And here's how. Talking about how Palantir is really in the central role of this AI revolution. And we're seeing these expanding cases for the products that it has for its future growth. And these seem to really have no limit. And talking about how AIP and how PLTR has been seeing significant demand for its enterprises and basically generative artificial intelligence and bringing utilities to all of these different types of clients. Now, Weebush right here really mentioned about the 1300 boot camps that we've seen. We've talked about this before, but with over 500 in the past 3 months alone, which really shows you here kind of, I want to say, the transition to these commercial clients that are trialing and increasing the conversion rates for utilizing AIP, which means spending money, bringing more revenue to Palantir. Now, a pivotal player is about the capitalization in the market cap here for this prediction, about the $1 trillion on AI spending this type of wave, and how Palantir is in the middle of this market share capitalization coming into AI stocks. They are a leading competitor, and I would say even one of the tops in the SaaS type industry regarding AI. So that's what he's using right now as a main justification for basically how much room for growth that there is. Now, Palantir, Forbes article is talking about this. We're going to be talking this right here. Earnings coming out August 5th. That's going to be happening post-market. We see 8 cents per share. That's what earnings per share is predicted, with 7 in the bullish direction and 2 in the bearish direction in terms of earnings per share revisions. Let's take a second to thank the sponsor of this video, Moomoo. Now, Moomoo is your one-stop trading app that offers free commission trading along with very powerful investment tools, making it easier for you to make those confident decisions within the market. Right now, new users can sign up utilizing my welcome bonus down in the description, and you can get up to 8.1% limited time APY on uninvested cash and up to 15 free stocks with a deposit. You also can get up to a $300 transfer in bonus. So you do not want to miss out on those rewards. Make sure you check out Moomoo down in the description. Back to the video. One thing that I do want to talk about with earnings is that this interesting article here talks about the rally is likely to continue after earnings. which is interesting because we've seen lots of people talked about the valuation. Forbes came out here with an article saying Palantir stock is really priced for perfection, basically saying that they need to keep hitting the bar, otherwise we could see a pullback. Buy the rumor. You usually hear sell the news, but talking about buy the rumor and buy more on the news, this is because what we're seeing is momentum that is coming behind POTR along with some bullish technical patterns that are all correlating and doing very well on top of these bullish predictions that are still continuing to be released. And this may not be enough to really break the bullish momentum. There's a lot of things that are coming together right now, and AI stocks are in high demand across the board. Palantir's quarterly earnings release, like I said, is coming up here in just a few short weeks, and it's really been hot along with the market rally that continues to be hot. Now, buy the rumor and buy more on the news. This elevated levels of expectations could continue to push PLTR past the 30s, which if we get that, I think the full stream right here, the full steam ahead for PLTR would enter it into a breakout zone. We haven't seen the 30s for a long, long time. And that's when I think you're going to see this kind of FOMO type of capitulation and psychology coming into the stock and kind of throwing evaluation out the window. And this is where we lead to what we're seeing in the market right now. Like I said, it's awesome to see PLTR having a green day in terms of red days in the market, is we're seeing a little bit of a pullback, especially here with mega cap tech plays. We're seeing some of the biggest Magnificent Seven stocks that are taking a little bit of a correction, and this is having a large impact on the S&P 500. One thing they do note here is there is some profit taking, and basically, with the AI boom that we've seen and with the profits that people have made, that just shows us the magnitude of the profits, and some profit taking is going to happen. I mean, that sometimes makes sense if these investors are up a crazy percentage. Now, the Fed changing their interest rates could be more of a key player to what we're seeing here with the change in momentum in the broader market. And with the optimism that we're seeing those first interest rates come September, this can help small cap stocks as it will decrease borrowing cost. However, some of the bigger names are going to take a little bit more of a hit. And that's what we're seeing here, a shift away from the big tech players. And that's exactly what we're seeing kind of throughout the week. Small cap stocks, though, Palantir Technologies could benefit from that with lower borrowing cost. I think once we typically do see, personally, we have the expectations, you know, that the market is going to eventually cut interest rates. We're seeing mortgage rates drop. We're seeing mortgage applications increase, refinance rates that are starting to increase. These expectations are good. And lowering inflationary rates, CPI data, showing signs of inflation cooling. This has also been good for the market. However, when the Fed actually says, hey, we're going to cut rates, that is, in a sense, a signal that the economy is not doing as well as it was. And that's where we could see the flip in the market, where we see a little bit of a pullback. I mean, look at how large the market has grown in just the last year. Some profit taking and a little bit of uncertainty could definitely be on the table. But that does not take away my bullishness for Palantir Technologies, because there's many other things than just interest rates that are going to affect Palantir. That still has a large chance for hopping on the exponential train in terms of the products that it can offer and accumulate from their clients. Now, let's talk about NVIDIA right here. Not a ton of things I want to get crazy into regarding NVIDIA. Basically, what we're seeing is semiconductor stocks that had exposure to China and Taiwan. They kind of have a sell-off that we've seen. mostly due to geopolitical concerns. And this is getting really into politics and what they're going to do in terms of exporting, importing, how they're going to work with these different countries. And of course, we're seeing different momentums and volatilities that are being incorporated in these semiconductor stocks. NVIDIA did have a little bit of a pullback. But this channel really doesn't get into politics. We're looking at the market, just dispatching the data. But we had NVIDIA come down about 6.6%. However, today, actually finishing up in the green, up about 2.6%. So good resilience here in terms for those people that are still keeping a bullish position on NVIDIA. That's all I have for you guys. Take care. Peace out. I want to know, what do you guys think is going to be happening with POTR? Do you, number one, agree with this Weebush prediction that we could possibly see a doubling for Palantir still? And do you think the 30s is in the near future? Let me know down in the comments. Take care.